ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देव महेश्वर गुरु साक्षात् परम ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। वी आर इन केनोपनिषद वर्स नंबर 2 एंड केनेशितम इन द फर्स्ट वर्स इट वॉज टोल्ड व्हाट इज दैट विच प्रॉम्प्ट्स इंस्पायर्स everything, the mind, etc. And in answer to that, now in the second verse, the teacher says, Shrotrasya Shrotram Manaso Mano Yad Vachoha Vacham Sahupranasya Vachoha Vacham Sahupranasya Pranaha Chakshushash Chakshuratimyuchadhiraha प्रेत्यास्मात् लोकाद् अमृता भवन्ति। दैट विच इज ईयर ऑफ द ईयर माइंड ऑफ द माइंड प्राण ऑफ द प्राण आय ऑफ द आय दैट इज दैट प्रिंसिपल अप्लाई टू योर सेल्फ राइट नाउ। व्हाट इज द आय ऑफ द आय माइंड ऑफ द माइंड इज द माइंड थिंकिंग बाय इटसेल्फ Is the eye seeing by itself or is there some power behind? Are the ears hearing by themselves? Are the thought coming by themselves? What is that force? What is that power? What is that which is that X factor which is we call it spirit, consciousness, awareness, reality, etc. But that's only at thought level. We need to directly experience it. Because as long as we are lost in being a seer, being a hearer, being a thinker, even though that principle is so close, yet it is very far. And the only contradictory language is going to work here. So the student teacher tells him that, as I said, that which is behind the ear, that which is behind the senses, that which is behind the mind, that is the principle that you are asking about. So here, what does the student teacher say? Shrotrasya shrotram shrunotya neteti shrotram shabdasya shravanam pratikaranam shabda bhivyanjakam shrotram indriyam yasya tasya shrotram sah yastvaya prushtah chakshu shrotram ka udevo yunakti iti. I'm trying to read the prose in a tune, but it didn't happen. वो पहले वाला tune अभी तक दिमाग में घूम रहा है. It doesn't work. So, what is this? श्रोत्रस्य श्रोत्रम् श्रुणोति श्रुणोति एने एन एनेति श्रोत्रम, तो श्रोत्र इज दैट विच बाय विच वी हियर. ईयर्स आर इनर्ट. ईयर इज देयर, देयर इज अ होल इन देयर, देयर इज अ ईयर लोब, देन देयर इज अ ईयर होल, एंड देन देयर इज अ ईयर ड्रम. डेड मैन ऑल्सो हैज दैट. सो आर द ईयर्स हियरिंग और इट इज दैट एबिलिटी, दैट प्रिंसिपल बिकॉज ऑफ विच द ईयर्स आर एबल टू हियर. सो श्रोत्र इज दैट बाय विच वी हियर, दैट विच इज एबल टू इल्यूमिनेट द साउंड्स. साउंड्स आर कमिंग इन डीप स्लीप, साउंड्स आर देयर. आर यू अवेलेबल? If you are in a reverie, in a dream, in an imagination, right here with eyes open, while I am giving lecture, and some issue is on your hand, and you are thinking about it, when you are thinking about that issue, someone's not well, some call has come from India, some accident of some near or dear or friend, or someone has just got into their finished their degree, someone just said I got a job, someone said or positive, negative, whatever, if it made an impact on your mind and you are carried away by that or you're thinking intense about that particular event, then even while you are listening to the satsang, you are not available for those few moments when your mind goes to that particular event which has have already happened. So were you listening? No. And this happens many times during the day because we don't know how to live alertly. Alertly does not mean being alert to the stimuli of the world. That does not mean alertness. I'm aware. I'm alert. Alert about what? I'm alertly listening. I'm alertly functioning in the world. Here a total shift is taken. Alertness is not to be practiced towards the world, towards the stimuli, because they are always there. But are we alert to the potential, to the power within, because of which the sounds are heard, sounds are illuminated, sounds are cognized. Form is cognized, colors are cognized, taste is cognized. Call it cognized, call it illuminated, call it grahan, grasped, whatever word you may use it. But these stimuli, and we see a dead man does not take in any stimuli. A living person does take stimuli, he is surrounded by stimuli, and yet if he is sleeping, he is not available to those stimuli. They can't invoke a reaction, he is not grasping them, he is not even aware that they are there when he is in sleep, when he is in meditation, or when he is in imagination. So here it is told that that which is able to illuminate sounds is that principle called Shrotram. Okay. And same is true with regards to all the other senses as well as the mind. Now, the student, when he listens to this answer by the teacher, he gets frustrated. I asked a straightforward question and you are giving me an answer in a roundabout way. Why are you not telling me straight what is required by me to be heard? So he says, asavevam vishishtah shrotradini niyunta iti vaktavye nanu etad anurupam prativachanam shrotrasya shrotramiti. He says that that this is not the right way of answering the question that I asked. You should have said what it is, and not that it is the ear of the ear, it is the eye of the eye, it is mind of the mind. It's a sign of frustration on the student's part. Now remember, the student has not, according to the Upanishad, he asked the question, teacher gave the answer. Adi Shankaracharya in his Bhashya is making it interesting for us so that we remain with the topic. Because it is a question answer between student and teacher, Guru Maharaj. What could be the possible reason as the Upanishad moves forward? So the teacher says, Naisha Doshaha, it is not your fault, man, it's okay, understood. Naisha Doshaha. Tasya Anyatha Visheshan Avagamat. Teacher says, what you have asked Keneshitam. Remember what he asked? Keneshitam. What is that which inspires? So teacher says Naisha Doshaha, that what the way I have answered is not wrong, because what you are asking, it does not have any specific qualities or attributes. So how do we explain something? Okay, anyway, let's see here what he says. That it does not have any special form. It does not have any special qualities. It does not have any special attributes. Now we are talking about the essence of ours. Now compare what you consider yourself to be and what you are actually. Then it will be a subjective approach. Don't collect information. So who are you? One without the self that you are is, here the topic of self hasn't come yet. But that principle is that which has got no attributes, no qualities, no form, no specificity. What do we consider ourselves as? I am mother, I am father, I am doctor, I am teacher, I am shishya, I am a devotee, I am a jnani, I am a Vedanti, I am a yogi, I am a waker, I am a dreamer, I am a meditator. You know, iska koi anti nahi hai. There is no end to this. No end to specificity that we thopify on ourselves. Thopify, you understand? Thopna. Thopne ko kya bolte hai? That we take on to ourselves unintelligently. So there's no special qualities. We have to reply in this manner. Teacher is not saying that you are at fault. Is that the way to speak to the teacher, that you are not right, giving me the correct answer and taking me roundabout, answering me in a roundabout way? Teacher is not affronted. See? पहले ही बड़ी मुश्किल से कोई स्टूडेंट आता है ऑफ दैट कैलिबर हु हैज वर्कड आउट दैट देर आर नो आंसर्स इन द वर्ल्ड, हु हैज वर्कड आउट देर आर नो आंसर्स इन द in the senses and the thought. So he has gone beyond, he has come brought them under control, he is not swayed by them. Then he is asking this question, who has gone beyond karta bhokta. So what is that student? He is udaseen, he is indifferent. But the question remains, how long will that udasinta continue? There is every possibility that if he is not established in the reality, there is every possibility that the world will take the better of him and he'll get caught up in the world. One slip, that's all is required. Number 99, snake and ladder. You are out of the board. Again you have to play the dice of life, of hard work, of your sadhana. Yadi hi shrotradi vyapara vyatiriktena swa vyaparena vishishtaha shrotradini yokta avagamyeta datradi prayokta vruta tade tad इदं अनुरूपं प्रतिवचनं स्यात् न त्वह श्रोत्रादीनां प्रयोक्ता स्वव्यापार विशिष्टः लवित्रादि वद अभि अधिगम्यते. तो ही सेज इफ दैट प्रिंसिपल वाज समथिंग स्पेशल, if it was something special then it would have been possible to describe it in some, by some words, by some qualities, by some attributes, taking support of something, we would have been able to explain it to you. If there was something special in it, see, if it was some, that principle was something special, then it would have been possible to describe. But he cannot be spoken of. Huh? He cannot be spoken of. Why? And therefore, why he cannot be spoken of? Question is, why can't we speak of that X factor? Why can't we speak of that spirit? We have given that particular name a spirit. Here there is no spirit, there is no consciousness, there is no, it's just called the principle, it or he. Why it has got no qualities? Because that particular principle has got nothing to gain from anything or anybody, and has got nothing to give anything to anyone or anybody. Be attentive. That principle has got nothing to gain and nothing to give. Who can give and who can gain? Where there is two, there is this interaction possible, isn't it? But it is one. So who will it give to and who will it take from? See? So, nothing to gain. Thus, that inspirer, that prompter of the mind and the senses cannot be described. So if we are trying to, I'm adding here, it's not given in the commentary, if we are trying to work it out in our intellect as regards the self, then we are lost in the mind only. Self is not a concept. Self is not a thought. If you say self is Sachidanand Swarup, Nitya Shuddha Buddha Mukta Swarup, Sarvam Kalviram Brahma, Brahmatmaikya Bodh, all these are pointers for the mind. These words are not it. What they indicate is it. So that principle, that reality, is it not Satchidanand? No, it is not Satchidanand. Then why did we use the word Satchidanand? Our Amrita Anubhav will tell. Sat is used to cancel asat, which we are addicted to, matter, non-existence, ignorance. Chit is used to cancel or neutralize achit. And Anand word is used to cancel dukkham. So once you have, so just like we use in 18th chapter, we are saying Satvik is used, prompted, invoked in order to cancel, neutralize, transcend the tamas and rajas. But because we are transcended, that is not the truth. You have to drop the sattva also. Similarly, this idea that this truth is Satchidanand also has to be dropped eventually. Then what is it indicating? That you find out that you are in essence, that you are in actuality. But we are lost at the mental level, at the thought level, at the conceptual level. This principle, this prompter, has no specific function to perform. It has got no specific function to perform. Then, just as you are doing a specific job of teacher, doctor, engineer, lecturer, listener, these are all specific jobs. Right now you are listening and seeing. You are not tasting, you are not smelling, you are not. Your attention, wherever your attention is, that you are doing right now. But this principle has got, because it has got no specific function, like we are at this very moment performing. So this prompter has got no special function. Then who is functioning? Mind is functioning. Who is functioning? The senses are functioning. Who is functioning? The limbs are functioning. Hand is functioning, leg is functioning, speech is functioning, five senses are functioning, mind is functioning, intellect is functioning. Is this prompter functioning? Is this prompter functioning? No. Is the sun comes up in the morning and there all activity begins on the earth. Wherever the sunrise happens, their activity begins. Not among human beings, at least in the animal kingdom it begins, because they get up at the right time. Brahma Murt. Human beings, their Brahma Muhurt begins at 11 o'clock, 10 o'clock, 12 o'clock, some of them 2 o'clock. So, is the sun equal to all the activities on the planet? Is the sun doing anything to the people to become active, or is it being just where it is? It is as it is. You tell it, as we saw in Amrut Anubhav, you tell it, thank you for heat and light, thank you for the morning, thank you for the beautiful sunrise, because without you, Brahma Muhurt will not be there. Without you, the night will not be there when we can go and rest and in the Brahma Muhurt get up and do our meditation. What will sun answer? He cannot answer anything, because everything that you are saying, Brahma Muhurt, you are talking about night, you are talking about day, you are talking about all the parts of the day. From sun's point of view, there is no day and there is no night. Sun has got nothing to gain by the activity on the earth, and sun has got nothing to give to anyone on the earth. You are taking it, it's your problem. And if you don't take it and remain in the bed till 2 o'clock, sun does not get affected. Correct or not? Similar is this prompter. Similar is this principle. Because of whom? All these intellect, mind, breath, senses, and the organs of action, everything becomes activated. So activity is where? Is the activity in the prompter? No. Where is the activity or manifestation of activity or unmanifestation of activity? It is at the equipment level. It is at the intellect, mind, pranas, and the organs of perception and action. And therefore, this prompter has got no specific qualities. And that is our experience, that all the activity is only at the equipment level. Isn't it? Sometimes the hearing is active, sometimes it is inactive. Sometimes we acutely smell like a dog, and other times, even in the midst of a stink, we can't hear, smell anything. Why? Is the self affected by that? No. Today this smell is coming, this form is coming, this sound is coming, this thought is coming, this imagination is coming, this waking is coming, this dream is coming, this sleep is coming, next day again another waking, dream and sleep is coming. Where are they happening? I'm asking, where are they happening? Where are the waking, dreaming and sleeping and meditation, where are they happening? Hello? Where are they happening? Are char baar pooch liya, koi to bolo. Are you all afraid to give the wrong answer? They are happening at the equipment level.
Yes, in the mind only.
It took you so long. Okay. They are only happening at the equipment level. Waking, the four avasthas, waking, dream, sleep and meditation, they are only expressions of the intellect. They are concepts in the intellect. They are not happening in the self. Anyway, let's get back to the Bhashyam. Therefore, this prompter from within, be subjective, this prompter from within has got no specific function to perform like we can perform specific functions and specific job for that matter. Therefore, Shrotradinameva tu samuhatanam vyaparena alochana sankalpa adhyavasaya lakshanena falavasana lingena avagamyate. So, therefore, it is very clear. What is clear? That all the assemblies of senses, thoughts, mind, intellect, etc., all these assemblies are seen functioning, and when they function, there is phalavyapti. Phalavyapti means there is a precipitation of a result. And how is the result taking place? As a thought in the mind, isn't it? My eyes are looking. I will not look at Usha and call her Surendran. Okay, that's going too far. Look at the form, and immediately that form comes into the mind along with the name. See? Phalavyapti. Phalavyapti means precipitation of a thought. Is phalavyapti. Remember, karma is, action is at kaya level, at the body level, at the speech level, and at the mind level. Because thoughts are also movements. So as eyes are looking, the form is getting precipitated, ears are listening, sounds are getting formed as thoughts in the mind, smell the same, everything. See? So in this way, yeah, the phalavyapti takes place. Therefore, if thoughts are precipitating in the mind, therefore there is someone other than these faculties, other than these thoughts or the senses. And we see that these faculties are not functioning by themselves. But they are functioning, they're not functioning for themselves, but are functioning prompted by someone. And we know it. We are seeing it. We are witnessing it. Isn't it? And if there is no prompter, if that prompter is not there, that inspirer is not there, will the faculties, senses and the mind, will they function? They will not function. They become as if neutralized. Are kya kare abhi? Therefore, astihi shrotradi birasam shrotradi bihi asamhatah यत् प्रयोजन प्रयुक्तः श्रोत्रादि कलापः गृहादि वदिति वद् गृहादिवत् इति। So who is this prompter? Who is this fellow or the principal, not fellow, principal? He is that who is not included in the faculties. Now this is your dissection going on right now. You do dissection in the lab. We are dissecting you right here. the Adi Shankaracharya. So this prompter is not a part and parcel of the faculties. Faculties, the word used is asamhata. Shrotradibihi asamhatah. यत् प्रयोजन प्रयुक्तः श्रोत्रादि कलापः गृहादिवद् इति। सो सम एसेंस इज देयर, सम प्रिंसिपल इज देयर विच इज अदर देन, एंड दैट इज द प्रॉम्प्टर, दैट इज द तत्व, दैट इज द एसेंस, दैट इज द इंस्पायरर, दैट इज द एक्स फैक्टर. Because if he was included in the faculties, then just like the faculties are manifesting and unmanifesting, then this fellow also, this principal will also manifest and unmanifest, isn't it? Go with the data. Nobody is saying that you have to imagine. Here nothing is to be imagined. Check this information as you are going listening right now with the data that you have in your daily life at this very moment. So asamhatah means that he is not included in the assembly of the faculties. Then संहतानां परार्थत्वाद् अवगम्यते श्रोत्रादीनां प्रयोक्ता. Because संहतानां परार्थत्वाद् अवगम्यते श्रोत्रादीनां प्रयोक्ता. Because assembly of different things are always meant for someone. The assembly is not meant for itself. The assembly of words are meant for the reader. The assembly of words is not for the book. Book cannot read. The assembly of the bricks and walls called house is meant for the person who is living in that house. The assembly of all the material that is used in building the house is not for the house. We are understanding? We are with it? So assembly of what? Assembly of organs of actions, assembly of five senses, assembly of thoughts, assembly of convictions, ideas, assembly of waker, dreamer, sleeper, meditator, ideas, imagination, concepts. They are not meant for themselves. They are meant for someone else. And that is the rule. You can observe it in your life at this very moment. I'm sitting on a chair, there is an armrest, there is a backrest, there are four legs, it has got swivel. Chair is not excited by all the faculties that it has, because it cannot enjoy itself. Similarly, the senses and the mind and the intellect, they cannot enjoy themselves. They are for someone. Just as car cannot drive itself, it is for someone. It cannot stop itself. It is, or someone has to stop it, isn't it? You can multiply the examples. See? So in this manner, this is the rule that the assembly of faculties are not for themselves, but they are for someone else. Now find out, we are talking about you. Be subjective. I keep repeating it because by grace it might click in this Upanishad, because first one went, we are still talking and you are still listening. तस्माद् अनुरूपम् एवेदं प्रतिवचनं श्रोत्रस्य श्रोत्रम् इत्यादि. Therefore, तस्माद् therefore it is rightly said, what is said, that therefore it is rightly said, that means this is the rule, it is rightly said, and what answer we gave, that shrotra se shrotram etc. is correct. Don't misunderstand.
Kah punaratra padartha shrotra se shrotram ityadehe.
Again, a doubt is raised by the student and he says that what is the meaning of shrotra se shrotram? What is the meaning of shrotrasya shrotram? And answer I have already given to you with the example of the sun. In the light of the sun, we see all the objects on the earth. So what is the light of all lights on the earth? O Lord Sun, please illuminate. He says, what is light? I don't know, therefore I cannot answer your question. Shut up. Therefore Dakshinamurti Sotram, a composition by Adi Shankaracharya. Shut up. It begins with shut up. Maunam Vyakhyat. Mouthshut.com. Swamiji says. The answer, what is the meaning of Shrotrasya Shrotram? A conclusive answer is meaningless, as a light does not require a light to illuminate it. Now, that was at a very relative level. I gave you the example of sun. Now go further. All the objects of the world are seen in the light of the sun. The sun is seen in the light of the vision. The vision is functioning in the light of the mind. And the mind is functioning in the light of whom? Very quickly we will answer, oh, in my light. Achat, you are that powerful. Which eye we are talking about? Are we talking about the waking eye? Are we talking about the ego eye? Are we talking about the mother eye, the father eye, the teacher eye, the student eye? Or are we talking about the absolute eye? And if we are talking about the absolute eye, nothing needs to be spoken. It is ever and ever and ever, and if we are speaking about it, then it's only a concept. So it does not require a light to illuminate it. Same way, a ear does not require another ear to illuminate it. The teacher, na hyatra shrotrasya shrotrantarena arthaha yatha prakashasya prakashantarena. One light is not required to illuminate another light. You cannot illuminate the sun by a candle light. You can. Light is light. Principle of light is expressing as at different levels in a different ways. And therefore, so therefore here it says, a light is not required to illuminate another light. An ear is not required to illuminate another ear. One thought is not required to illuminate another thought. If you go further, if I can, it's not written here, but if I add this light which we are talking about is self-existing, self-illumined. It does not require another. It cannot be known by another. All faculties fail in front of it because it is the light of all lights. And how are we trying to grasp it at this moment? Through our intellect. Through listening, we are forming some idea, some concept, some inquiry. But if we remain lost in the thoughts, we will miss the plot. It requires a very, very, this is called the razor's edge. Naisha doshaha. It's not your fault to think like this, the student teacher is telling him. This is the doubt of the student. Naisha doshaha. Ayam atra padarthaha. Shrotram tavat swavishaya vyanjanas vyanjana samartham drishtam. That I'll tell you. Tattu swavishaya vyanjana samartya shrotrasya chaitanya yatma dyotishi nitya asamhate sarvantare sati bhavati na asati iti. अतः श्रोत्रस्य श्रोत्रम् इत्यादि उपपद्यते तथा च श्रुत्यन्तराणि आत्मनैवायं ज्योतिषास्ते इट्स टोल्ड इन बृहदारण्यक उपनिषद तस्य भाषा सर्वमिदं विभाति कठोपनिषद येन सूर्यस्तपति तेजसेद्ध तैत्रेय उपनिषद इत्यादि. सो Naisha doshaha. No. Ears are able to function. Shrotra tavat swavishaya vyanjana samartha drishtam. The ears are able to function and become useful only when in association with the conscious principle. Okay. Only then they become functional. And what is this consciousness? What is this conscious principle? Asamhata. Independent. It is not identified with the faculties. So the consciousness that is, who are you at this moment? Are you the listener? Are you the understander? Are you the seer? Are you the listener? Are you the conceptualizer? Or are you the one who's watching that all this is going on. Seeing is going on at the eye level, hearing is going on at the ear level, thoughts are forming of the stimuli that are coming through the senses in the mind. That data is immediately at a very fast pace, because we have become, our intellect has practiced a lot since childhood. Immediately it puts it into boxes. Ah, I understand this. Yeah, I have read this before. It's very clear. It's very simple. No confusion there. This is intellect speaking. It has got nothing to do with the conscious principle. Let all words are in the mind. And consciousness has got nothing, conscious principle, because of which the mind is functioning, has got nothing to do with the mind. Mind is coming and going, mind is continuously in the flux, mind is manifesting thoughts and unmanifesting thoughts. Conscious is not doing all that. Conscious is not coming and going, conscious is not manifesting or unmanifesting, conscious is not in the flux. It's ever the same. Is that not your experience at this moment? Sounds are coming and going, time is coming and going. Understanding is coming, happening or not happening. Even if the intellect says, I understand or I don't understand, this statement also is known by someone, isn't it? Is illumined by someone. How can you say that? Because you know that this statement came in the mind. It was formulated in the mind by way of thoughts. I understood that. This thought erupted in your mind. Man, that was very, very nicely put, and Adi Shankaracharya is doing fantastic. It's making it so simple. Mind is saying that. Don't you know that mind just thought that? Then who is this fellow in whose light these thoughts, this statement, this understanding happened? So this conscious principle is asamhata, means it is the essence, it is unidentified with the faculties. Asamhata is that it is not dependent on anything, it is not entangled in anything, therefore asamhata is the common denominator. It is the common denominator. It is the constant. Do you consider yourself to be the constant? Or do you go as the yo-yo with the thoughts and emotions? Or you go as a yo-yo with the, abhi waking a gaya, oh, I have to go to work, I have to go to this, abhi afternoon a gaya, I am so tired, I need a coffee to take me through next 3 hours. Then night a gaya, thank God, I am looking forward to sleep, I am so tired. Are you considering yourself to be that one? Or are you, at this very moment, while listening is going on, understanding is going on, stimuli are coming in, you take yourself to be the constant principle, you take yourself to be the common denominator. Let the mind react to the stimuli or not react to the stimuli, how does it matter? It is doing whatever it is doing based on the data that it has stored from before. See? Just as without the sun there can be no day or night. Similarly, sun is the constant principle. This conscious principle is the constant principle, common denominator. It alone, in its presence, in the mind and intellect, the aham vritti and the idam vritti, the I and that, get prompted. Just as from the sun's point of view, there is no light day and night, similarly, from the conscious principle point of view, there is no aham vritti and idam vritti. Just as from water point of view, there is nothing called ocean or wave. Take this position, accept yourself to be that, at this very moment. And this constant principle that we just mentioned, that it is the common denominator, this is seconded by many other Upanishads, and therefore the various Upanishads were given Atma Naivayam Jyotishaste Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, that it is illumined by its own light. Just as sun is illumined by its own light, same way this Atmana eva ayam jyotishaste means it is illumined by its own light. Tasya bhasa sarvam idam vibhati, this is om na tatra suryo bhati na chandatarakam nema vidyato bhanti kutoyam agnihi tameva bhantam anubhati sarvam tasya bhasa sarvam idam vibhati. This is that it comes in Kathopanishad, that in its light everything else gets illuminated. You can see light. I am reading in the light from the lamp. But can you see electricity? From electricity point of view, is there anything called light? Not possible. So from consciousness point of view, this conscious principle point of view, is there anything called I? Aham? Is there anything called idam? The day you accept yourself to be that common denominator, a major shift in your spiritual journey will happen. We are too caught up in the relations and possessions. Why we are caught up in relations and positions? Because we are caught up in this body first. We are too caught up that I am, you know, professor, I am a sannyasi, I am a doctor, I am retired, I am a sadhaka, I am a Vedanti, I am a devotee. We have created so many specificities with respect to ourselves that God is confused now. Which one is he? You see? He is confused. Tasya bhasa sarvam idam vibhati.
येन सूर्यस्तपति तेजसेद्धः. इन तैत्तिरोपनिषद इट सेज इट इज दैट कॉमन डिनोमिनेटर, इट दैट कॉन्शियसनेस इज दैट कॉन्शियस प्रिंसिपल सेल्फ इल्यूमिंड इन हूज लाइट द होल वर्ल्ड गेट्स इल्यूमिंड एंड इट इज दैट लाइट because of which the sun also is hot. Without that common denominator, the sun cannot get the heat and light. It cannot get hot also. So these are the four different Upanishads quoted to show that. Because see, the student was caught up in Shrotrasya Shrotram. Why do we need another ear to hear one ear? Right now, this is what is happening. What is happening? You are listening and I am talking. So, my mouth and your ears. Your mind and my grossified mind called speech. When we are at the faculty level, this is the understanding. Shrotrasya Shrotam, very basic level, this is what is the understanding. But the teacher says, no, it is the, don't think. Think outside the box. We are talking about that common denominator. We are talking about that constant principle. We are talking about that conscious principle in whose presence everything gets activated. Continuing with the examples, yad aditya gatam tejo jagat bhasayate khilam. Kshetram, that comes in Gita 15th chapter. Kshetram Kshetri Tadhakrutsnam Prakashayati Bharata. Gita 13th chapter Iti Cha Gita Su. So here it says that Yadaditya Gadham Tejo Jagat Bhasayate Khilam. The one who being established in the sun illuminates the whole world. So don't consider this conscious principle to be only the location called this faculty. Not only behind this faculty. He is in the sun also. He is everywhere. Isha vasya medagam sarvam yat kinchit jagat tyam jagat. It is the dharma of everything. Water is the dharma of every ocean and wave. Gold is the dharma of the essence of every ornament. Similarly, this conscious principle, it is not at one location within you. Don't make that mistake. If you do that, then you have to pay stamp duty. This is my house space, gone. Then find different ways of avoiding stamp duty. No, it is infinitely available. Well, it is. It is the constant, it is the common denominator. And therefore, it is that because of which the sun is able to illuminate the whole world. Kshetram Kshetri Tatha Krishnam Prakashayati Bharata. O Arjuna, O Bharat. This constant principle is that which not only which illuminates Kshetram Kshetri. See? in the 13th chapter, what was the kshetra, kshetrajna vibhaga yoga nama, hai na? So all the knowers and all the known. The conscious principle as well as the matter principle, it is illuminating, relatively speaking. So it is illuminating the waker and the waking world. It is illuminating the dreamer and the dream world. See? Kshetra, kshetram, kshetri. Then, kathakecha, nityo, nityanam, chetanas, chetananam. Again, in Kathopanishad, it says that it is the eternity of the eternal, and it is the conscious, it is the consciousness of the conscious. चेतनस चेतनानाम इति श्रोत्राद्येव यद्येव सर्वस्य आत्मभूतं चेतनम इति प्रसिद्धं तद् तद् इह निवर्तयेत. Here it says that it is said so. It is said so because of eyes, ears, etc. We see, hear, etc. But it is wrong. You don't see because of ears and eyes. Because actually it is due to the conscious principle. If consciousness was not there, eyes cannot see. If consciousness is not there, ears cannot hear. If consciousness is not there, mind cannot think. If consciousness is not there, the breath cannot breathe, go in and out. If consciousness is not there, intellect cannot intellectualize, think. So it is wrong to conclude. Here when it says Shrotradyeva sarvasya atmabhutam chetanam iti prasiddham tad iha nivartate nivartaye nivartyate ha. That it is the atma of everything, of all. And this everyone knows. But nobody gives attention to that. Nobody accepts it to be their reality. Therefore, asti, asti kimapi, what is the word? Vidvat buddhi gamyam sarvantaratamam kutastham ajam ajaram amrutam abhayam shrotrad श्रोत्रादेहे अपि श्रोत्रादि तत् सामर्थ्य सामर्थ्य निमित्तम् इति प्रतिवचनम् शब्दार्थ शब्दार्थः उपपद्यत एव. सो देयर इज समथिंग विच इज अनबॉर्न विच गिव्स द एबिलिटी टू द इयर्स आईज एक्सेट्रा. सी इवन द आई थॉट comes with every knowledge, and it I see Usha, I is gone, Usha is gone, I see Ravi, now I and again I is born again along with the Ravi, then it goes away, then I see Meena, again I is born along with Meena. So this I, which I consider myself to be the continuous one, but are you the continuous one? When you are focused on the objects, can you be the continuous one? Yes and no, because in essence I am the continuous, but imagining that I am the continuous as the thought. That is not possible, because I is coming and going with everything, with every object, with every idam aham is born. And we have seen it in Panchadashi and other texts, that it is happening so fast that there is an imaginary continuity of this aham. Just like there is one sparkler, and if you take it full jhadi, and if you take it round and round at a great speed, it is one. But you see a continuous circle, exactly the same way. There is only one aham, but the thoughts are happening at such a great speed that you feel there is continuity of the aham. And that is the ego. That is the ghost. So now, are we considering ourselves to be the ghost I, or are we the real I? See? Yeah, how much? And then we wonder why it, if we understand everything, why it is not clicking. This is the reason. This I thought is born with every object of cognition, with every experience this I is born. But this conscious principle, is it born? Every day the waker is born, the dreamer is born, the sleeper is born, and they go away. Who is the one who knows that they are coming and going every day? Is that fellow born every day? Or he is the continuous one? Right now, catch it. So all those who are the knowers of truth, they know it to be that it is the innermost, that it is the anvil, that it is unborn, that it is undying, it is immortal, and it is fearless. These are the different adjectives that they give it to. So therefore, the teacher is concluding, telling that whatever answer I gave you, Shrotrasya Shrotram, all that from word point of view and as well as from meaning point of view, it is correct answer I gave you. Iti prati vachanam shabda artha cha upapadyata eva. तथा मनसः अंतःकरणस्य मनः. Now having move, we are moving from श्रोत्र, the five senses. Now we are coming to mind. Maybe I am interpolating mind and intellect also. I was talking before, but let's see. तथा मनसः अंतःकरणस्य मनः. In this manner, this constant principle is also the mind of the mind. Just like it was the ear of the ear, eye of the eye, it is also the mind of the mind, without association. Without association of the consciousness, the mind cannot function. If there is no consciousness, mind cannot pop up thoughts. The mind cannot go through the waking dream, deep sleep meditation. It cannot go through this cycle. It cannot forget about waking dream, deep sleep. It cannot ideate, it cannot intellectualize, it cannot have doubts, it cannot be confused. It is able to do, mind is able to do or feel emotions. It is not able to do that, all these things, if there is no consciousness. If there is no conscious principle, mind will not be able to function the way it functions as we experience it at this moment. न ह्यन्तकरणम् अन्तरेण चैतन्य ज्योतिषो दधितिम् स्वविषय संकल्पाध्यवसायादि समर्थ स्यात् तस्मात् मनसो मनसः अपि मन इति इह बुद्धि मनसि एकीकृत्य निर्देशो मनस इति. Because of the light of consciousness alone, that the antakaran, and what is antakaran? Mana, buddhi, chitta, hankar. These are the four. That is antakaran chatushtay. Mind, intellect, memory, and ego. Mind is where either you can say the emotions come or thoughts come. Thoughts erupt. Pop-ups. And the pop-ups come because of the stimuli or from inside. Mana, buddhi. Buddhi is which intellectualizes, conceptualizes, and etc. imagines. Buddhi. Mana, buddhi, chitta. Chitta is the memory. They are also as thoughts only. Concepts are also thoughts. Confusions and doubts are also thoughts. Memories are also thoughts. And the one who owns all this is the ahankar, I. That is also a thought. So, and this antakaran together is called the mind. This together is called the mind. That mind, because of the quality of thoughts, there is functional difference. That thought which is of the quality of confusion and doubt is called mind. That which is decisive is called intellect. That which is of the past is called chitta, memory. That which owns everything is called the ahankar. All of them are thoughts only. And without this light of consciousness, the antakaran cannot function properly. Therefore, it is this constant principle, this conscious principle is the mind of the mind. So understand these statements, Shrotrasya Shrotam Manasa, what is that? Shrotrasya Shrotram Manaso Manoyat. Understand these statements in this manner. Mind of mind is very simple statement, but see the where the Adi Shankaracharya ji is taking us. Excuse me. Iti buddhi manasi eki krutya nirdesho manasa iti. Here it is told that mind and intellect has to be taken as one alone. Eki krutya. There is only functional difference, that's all. Yad vachoha vacham. Now it's coming to the speech of the speech. He's taking everyone, every part of it. Yad vachoha vacham. Yad shabdo yasmad arthe shrotradibihi sarvaihi sambadhyate. Yasmad shrotrasya shrotram. Yasmad manaso manas iti evam. Yadvacho, because it is also speech of the speech, when we disassociate from different faculties, we come to know it. then only essential self remains behind, only the conscious principle remains behind, and that is what is our true identity. Are we lost in the words at the moment? We are saying, but see, every line that is being spoken here by Adi Shankaracharya in his Bhashya is taking us back to that constant principle that is our true identity. Not only Shrotrasya Shrotram, not only Manaso Manaha. What is that? Yad Vachoha Vacham. Then Pranasya Pranaha. It will come next one. Everyone is taking. Vedanta is not to establish anything but the conscious principle. And it has to use the language in such a manner that we are able to shoot out of the gravity of this matter. Matter meaning everything other than the conscious principle is matter. And that matter is nothing but imagination of the antakaran. That's all. And for that, a certain acumen has to be had. And that acumen cannot come only by reading books. It cannot come by... It requires some level of purification. Purification means some level of even while functioning in this world, some level of udasinta towards the world and indifference towards the world on one hand, and urge, a deep urge to abide in the conscious principle as it is. This urge will not get invoked, ignited. This spark will not happen until unless the purification is not there. Today only one Greek boy, I know him from last 25 years. If I read, I'll take it out next time. Very interesting what he wrote. And he wanted to clarify the doubt. That mind is functioning, intellect is functioning, breath is functioning, senses are functioning. I'm very clear they are functioning, but I am that. Then what do I do? Sometimes I find myself in here, but I'm very clear that I am not it. But then sometimes, before I know, I lost the plot and suddenly I catch it and again. And this has been going on for so many years now. I'll read the whole big SMS he sent me. Continuing, Vachoha Vachamiti Dvitiya Prathamatvena Viparinamyate Pranasya Prana Iti Darshanat. Here it is little bit something about Sanskrit is given, and what is that? That we should change the Dvitiya Vibhakti to Prathama Vibhakti, from accusative to nominative, the Vacha. Vachasya what is it? Vachoha vacham it was given, no? So, vachaha cha vacham, ha vacham. So, vacham is accusative and vachaha is prathama. So, here it says that dvitiya vibhakti to prathama vibhakti, that is in the nominative, and then it should be understood. Now again, vachoha what is it? Vachoha vacham iti etad anurodhena pranasya pranam iti kasmad dvitiya eva na kriyate. Student says, why not do the same with prana and say pranasya pranam? If you say vachoha vacham, then why don't you say where are we? Then why can't we do the same thing, pranasya pranaha? Why don't you take that also in the nominative? Why is different rule there and different rule here? A little bit grammatical. So the teacher says here, no. Bahunam anurodhasya yuktatvat vacham ityasya vag iti etavat vaktavyam sau pranasya prana iti shabda dvayanurodhena rodhena evam hi bahunam anurodho yukta kruta syat. So he says no. That it should be understood as that it should be understood as vachasya vak. Thus, that whatever should the teacher says, that what should be understood, that it should be understood as vachasya vak, and as a result, the majority of the thought is respected only when something is indicated, and that person is always in the nominative case. Nominative means first person. Nominative means first person, second person, third person, but in the nominative case. See, in Sanskrit there is prathama, dvitiya, tritiya, chaturthi, panchami. That means nominative is the noun, accusative is the action, the object of the noun, tritiya, third, vibhakti is the instrument with which the noun, the person, is performing the action, and it goes so on. So if the noun is not there, the sentence cannot be complete. Whether that noun is a pronoun, I, you, we all, you all, he, she, it, they, these are the pronouns, or there should be a person. Ravi is going. You cannot say going. Who is going? I am going, he is going, she is going, it is going, that person Ravi is going, Usha is going. Just going has got no meaning. Verb has got no meaning without a noun or a pronoun. So that's what is told here. Therefore, what was asked in the mantra is indicated in the nominative case and not to be changed to accusative case. Technical data, don't get confused. Keep your focus on the constant principle. Suddenly in between, this is because it's
the Upanishadic Sanskrit is a little bit different, and because it is coming in the Vedas, there are some discrepancies, but and those discrepancies are being addressed by Adi Shankaracharya ji. We do not change the Upanishads because we feel there is a grammatic mistake. We continue the leave the Upanishad as it is, and what is told, don't you say, hey, sometimes if someone has misunderstood you, you say, oh, I meant that way, and then the misunderstanding is over. Same way, what is told here, the misunderstanding is being clarified by Adi Shankaracharya ji through the grammar of Sanskrit, because the Vedic grammar is very old. And Adi Shankaracharya came only in the 8th century, much, much later. Vedic grammar is very old. So we do not correct the Vedas. We can give arguments that it could be this, it could be that way. And that's what Adi Shankaracharya is doing, because what he is saying is making sense if it is taken grammatically. Tatha chakshushas chakshuhu rupa prakashakasya chakshusho yad rupa grahana samarthyam tad atma chaitanya adishthitasya eva atah chakshushas chakshuhu. And in this way, and in the similar way, that infinite reality, that constant principle is the eye of the eye, and illuminating all the forms. That ability which is behind the eye to illuminate all colors and forms is his, and that ability behind the eyes, because of which you can, because of which the forms and colors are perceived, is coming from that atmic principle, from that constant principle. See, that therefore he is the eye of the eye. And someone did not tell me that it is already past 9 o'clock. We stop here. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.
Thank you, Swamiji.
Hari Om.